Please raise your hand if you know what a boquita is. Well, if you didn't know, the boquita is a species of porpoise, characterized by a notable dark circle around its eye. The boquita, according to the World Wildlife Fund, is considered to be the world's rarest mammal, and this is because there's only about 10 left in existence. I want to help you all understand the extremity of wildlife endangerment today, and what each of us can do to prevent further environmental catastrophe. Today, we're going to look at the current state of endangered species, why we should conserve wildlife, what has been done to protect wildlife in their habitats, and what you can do to save dying species such as the boquita. Today, endangered species are dying faster than they ever have before. According to a report released by the UN in May of 2019, the rate of species extinction is already at least tens to hundreds times higher than it has averaged over the past 10 million years, and it is set to rise sharply still further unless drivers are reduced. The World Wildlife Fund says that boquita weren't discovered until 1958 and are only known to be found in Mexico's northern Gulf of California. Boquitas are commonly caught and killed using gill nets, and this occurs in protected areas of the Gulf. So it makes sense that here we are only 63 years later when they are about to go completely extinct. The boquita is one of thousands of species on the Red List of Threatened Species, which was created by and is monitored by the International Union for Conservation of Nature, or the IC, or the IUCN. According to the IUCN, the Red List is the largest source of information on the global status of plant animal species, having assessed the status of 138,374 species so far, with the goal of assessing 160,000 total. The IUCN also states that of these species, 38,500 are already at risk of extinction, and an article from Down to Earth states that 902 species are already extinct. IUCN states that the Red List categorizes species into 9 different categories based on their population. These categories are not evaluated, data deficient, least concern, near threatened, vulnerable, endangered, critically endangered, extinct in the wild, and of course extinct. The boquita is considered to be critically endangered according to the IUCN because of its almost non-existent population size, and the Red List is updated at least twice yearly. According to an article written by Daniel Stolpe, researchers at the University of Arizona wanted to predict the effects of climate change on future species populations. So, using evidence from recent extinctions caused by climate change, as well as migration patterns and potential future climates, they predict that by the year 2070, 1 in 3 threatened animal species will likely go extinct, unless warming rates reduce. Plant animal species are dying at a never-before-seen rate, but they have so much value that it's worth saving. According to an article from Encyclopedia.com, there are 4 prominent reasons why we should conserve all species. First meaning, all living beings have a natural right to life, and we have a moral and ethical obligation to preserve those rights. Second, many species have an already established role in our economy and are valuable in maintaining this economic stability. Third, there are plenty of unidentified and even undiscovered species that have an undetermined economic and resourceful value to humans. Finally, most species have a functional role in their own environment, as well as that of humans, that could be central to our predator. The realization that these species are worth saving has come to light in recent decades, with many national governments taking up this environmental matter. Like legislation has been proposed, discussed, and recognized, with some enactments making real strides for the wildlife conservation community. According to an article in encyclopedia.com, U.S. Congress passed the Endangered Species Preservation Act in 1966 and the Endangered Species Conservation Act in 1969. This article also states that both of these acts drew necessary attention to wildlife preservation and listed numerous species as endangered. However, these acts didn't do much to prevent the extinction of species which is already occurring. This same article also states that Congress passed the Marine Mammal Protection Act in 1972, which protects marine mammals against harmful human practices such as the hunting, capturing, and killing of mammals in U.S. waters, but also prohibits U.S. citizens from committing any of these acts anywhere else in the world. The article also states that this act prohibits the import of animal products such as seal furs and walrus tusks into the U.S. The article also states that it is the responsibility of the Department of the Interior, as well as the Department of Commerce's National Marine Fisheries Service, to enforce this act, as well as monitor and potentially foster the populations of particular marine mammals. The same article also states that what is widely regarded as one of the most influential pieces of conservation legislation, also known as the Endangered Species Act of 1973, which aims to protect endangered species and their habitats so that their population may regrow and be taken off the list later. Another encyclopedia.com article states that the Endangered Species Act identifies species as endangered, meaning that they have a legitimate risk of going extinct, or as threatened, meaning they have the potential of becoming endangered. The same article states that critics of the act say that it's too restrictive over development projects and it's too expensive for the amount of work that's accomplished. However, supporters of the act state that it has saved numerous species and their habitats, and it is well worth the financial costs. The fight to protect wildlife has been an ongoing battle for decades. And despite the great triumphs of government legislation, the future of our wildlife doesn't look too promising. But we can change that. To summarize what we've covered so far, we've looked at current statistics on endangered species. Looked at four reasons why the conservation of all species is important. We've looked at large pieces of legislation that protect endangered species and their habitats. Wildlife preservation has come a long way since the 1960s, yet the situation is still dire. So what can you do to help? I want to challenge each of you to go to the World Wildlife Fund's website, go to their Action Center, and do at least one of the following. Make a donation of whatever you can to support the organization's work towards global conservation. Virtually adopt an animal or an endangered species from their website. Or sign a petition to protect an endangered species or their habitat from harmful human practices like deforestation or mass pollution. And finally, I would like to leave you with a quote from Paul Oxman, who is the founder and CEO of Wild Heart Wildlife Foundation. Oxman states, "There may be days when I can't help an animal in need, but the day will never come that I don't try." Thank you.